Speak English fluently. Synchronized reading practice, beginner to intermediate level. Exercise 1, Mahatma Gandhi. Instructions: turn up the volume so the teacher's voice is loud. 2, read the words in red out loud at the same time as the teacher. And 3, pay attention to the teacher's voice intonation and the word groups. Let's start. Mahatma Gandhi was an Indian lawyer and anti-colonial nationalist who employed non-violent resistance to lead the successful campaign for India's independence from British rule. In turn, he inspired movements for civil rights and freedom across the world. The honorific Mahatma, Sanskrit, great-souled, venerable, first applied to him in 1914 in South Africa, is now used throughout the world. Born and raised in a Hindu family in coastal Gujarat, western India, Gandhi trained in law at the Inner Temple, London, and was called to the bar at age 22 in June 1891. After 2 uncertain years in India, where he was unable to start a successful law practice, he moved to South Africa in 1893 to represent an Indian merchant in a lawsuit. He went on to stay for 21 years. It was in South Africa that Gandhi raised a family and first employed non-violent resistance in a campaign for civil rights. In 1915, aged 45, he returned to India. He set about organizing peasants, farmers, and urban laborers to protest against excessive land tax and discrimination. Assuming leadership of the Indian National Congress in 1921, Gandhi led nationwide campaigns for easing poverty, expanding women's rights, building religious and ethnic amity, ending untouchability, and above all, achieving self-rule. The same year, Gandhi adopted the Indian loincloth, or short dhoti, and, in the winter, a shawl, both woven with yarn handspun on a traditional Indian spinning wheel, as a mark of identification with India's rural poor. Thereafter, he lived modestly in a self-sufficient residential community, ate simple vegetarian food, and undertook long fasts as a means of self-purification and political protest. Bringing anti-colonial nationalism to the common Indians, Gandhi led them in challenging the British-imposed salt tax with the 400-kilometre, 250-mile Dandi Salt March in 1930, and later in calling for the British to quit India in 1942. He was imprisoned for many years on many occasions in both South Africa and India. Gandhi's vision of an independent India based on religious pluralism was challenged in the early 1940s by a new Muslim nationalism, which was demanding a separate Muslim homeland carved out of India. In August 1947, Britain granted independence, but the British Indian Empire was partitioned into 2 dominions, a Hindu-majority India and Muslim-majority Pakistan. As many displaced Hindus, Muslims, and Sikhs made their way to their new lands, religious violence broke out, especially in the Punjab and Bengal. Instead of observing the official celebration of independence in Delhi, Gandhi visited the affected areas, attempting to provide solace. In the months following, he undertook several fasts unto death to stop religious violence. The last of these, undertaken on January 12, 1948, when he was 78, also had the indirect goal of pressuring India to pay out some cash assets owed to Pakistan. Some Indians thought Gandhi was too accommodating. Among them was a Hindu nationalist who assassinated Gandhi on January 30, 1948, by firing 3 bullets into his chest. Gandhi's birthday, on October 2, is commemorated in India as a national holiday and worldwide as the International Day of Non-Violence. Gandhi is commonly, though not formally, considered the father of the nation in India and was commonly called Bapu, Gujarati, a term of endearment for father, Papa. Well, that's the end of the reading. Repeat this exercise many times until you can synchronize your reading with the teacher. Practice other exercises in this playlist and see a major improvement in your English-speaking fluency. Has this video helped you? Hit like now and continually improve your English by subscribing to this channel. Just hit the subscribe button now, click the bell icon, and choose all to be notified when there are new videos. Build a powerful English vocabulary with my free course on Udemy. Go to goodenglish.online.